pursue.
God's gonna shut these niggas out. Called divine intervention. I been not gave a fuck, now I don't give a fuck more. I been shot, been persecuted by the law. I got my own people coming to attack. But guess how I go in the hood when you black. Man, this shit whack like a Joe Button track. Some say, damn, why you saying that? He smiled to my face and my back spoke crap. Pumped up to talk, damn, who gassed that? Jealousy is fake. Seen boy do the same shit to Drake. We both fuck women that he date. When it come to hoes, he wears a cake. I wear an icy face, but no time being spent on a bum bitch. I'm a rich nigga, but I'm on a dumb shit. Hating ass nigga, I don't fuck with. Got my name in your mouth with a comfy. You a drug addict and a bitch beater. Rap podcast and a dick eater. Tryna see how my boss says, ask your chick, she in a vid lick in my face. Nasty? And when you ask about it, she say, Joey, don't slap me. He's a bitch, dog. Truth is light, I send these lames. Niggas won't get away with my name. Troy Ave is hot, they want the flame. Nigga rears down the hill, I'm born the plane. Truth is light, I send these lames. Niggas won't get away with my name. Troy Ave is hot, they want the flame. Nigga rears down the hill, I'm born the plane. These dweebs call me a bozo from their perspective. Of course you can't understand, nigga, that's getting this money. We broke, it's what I expected. Niggas be cold, trying feet on feet. My farms get Joe while they be on feet. Mad as fuck, sad as fuck, calloused up. Times is hard, life is rough. No dice, mics, and the hope for real. It's been 20 years since your record deal. You need a dad or Uncle Phil. Someone to say it ain't right to steal. You crowded court like a fucking deal. Pickle nigga, use a fickle nigga. You 44 don't mean shit, little nigga. Fecal matters, eat shit, little nigga. Talk to me about shit, little nigga. You apologize to the guy. You ride for a ring and money a bottle point when he was giving you a cabbie ride. Crackhead, you doing crimes like a blackhead. Crackhead, get on my top like a blackhead. You the general of general admission. Outside the club, no bread to get it. You go click the click, get the dick. Oh, little nigga, I didn't forget. Remember you was signed to the game? What happened to the Rough Rider thing? I remember seeing you outside my show in the fucking rain. Yelling, yo, Joey, have you doing your thing? Niggas talk shit out the same lips that they suck dick. Niggas talk shit out the same lips that they suck dick. Why do niggas suck dick out the same lips that they talk shit? I don't do shit. You niggas is bitch. Don't act like you don't remember, nigga. It was Apollo. I'm sitting in the back. The bum ass coat on the rain. The stupid fucking face. Stupid fucking Sesame Street face. These dweebs called me a weirdo from their perspective. Cause you can't understand, nigga, that's getting his money when you broke. It's what I expected. Listen, these dweebs called me a weirdo from their perspective. Cause you can't understand, nigga, that's getting his money when they broke. It's what I expected. I made you boy, I gave you fame. Gave you a lounge, gave you the game. I let you rep, I made you gang. Now it's a shame you ran her vein. Niggas ain't show up to the hospital when I was shot. That means that the bitch made ain't great, so everything I done for him, they forgot. It's sad cause I really had love for him. Was down to die and catch slugs for him. But when your boy needed help, I looked around and damn, it wasn't none for him.
My closest friends did me in. My closest friends, my homies, people who I done took care of their whole family. I done took care of everything for them, looked out for them, put them in the game, everything turned on me. Fear is stronger than love. Remember that. Fear is stronger than love. All the love I gave didn't mean nothing when it came to fear. So it's all good. But I'm a soldier. I always survive. I constantly come back.
No. What was the new shit we were just talking about just now? Oh, Troy F. I had a guest coming. And I don't have guests coming.
Let's not say who we had coming because we might still have.
No, I ain't having them.
Another date?
No.
I don't think that'll pass. That's something that needs to be addressed.
Well, when I spoke to him, he was like, "It's not much I could say because of legal matters, of course." And then I said, "You know, I said I really just want you there so you can confirm the amount of times that I tried to intervene."
Oh, so this is about you, not even the fans.
I'm a narcissist, Rory. Mm-hmm. I find a way for everything to be about me. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I agree with
all
that.
Your beefs.
Am I a narcissist?
Look at everything coming full circle. You beef the most because, oh, wow, we're making some progress here.
I know.
You might be a culture forwarder. I see where you're going with this.
See? Finally.
Yeah. No, he's a Joe forwarder. Yeah. It's all about him. He just happens to be in the culture.
If I'm a Joe forwarder. I should have been fired from being a Joe forwarder.
Right. But like you were saying, he couldn't talk about it. Because
he couldn't talk about it because of legal matters. And I wanted him to come here because I tried to intervene multiple times just to say something. Partly because I cared. Another part just because it was issues that I'm sensitive with, i.e. suicide, i.e. depression, i.e. weirdos. Troy Ave on his way up, he dissed all of those things a lot. So because Hovain, I think, is a cool dude, I hit him. I've spoken to Troy about this. Like, I just tried. I say all that to say I watched that Doggy Diamond interview where Banger's brother, Trife Gangsta, was interviewed. Real good interview. Shout out to Doggy Diamonds. I then watched the Troy Ave interview with The Breakfast Club. I then hit my group chat about the Troy Ave interview on Breakfast Club. Then I text all my friends that weren't in my group chat and said, y'all should watch the Troy Ave interview on The Breakfast Club. Then I invited friends over to my house to watch the Troy Ave interview on The Breakfast Club. And then that night, I watched the Troy Ave interview again with my girl on The Breakfast Club. Now that I've said that, that's probably one of the greatest interviews I've ever seen in my life. That's number one.
10 times.
Number two, I'm afraid of Troy Ave. Mm-hmm. I'm scared to death for him, and I am scared to death of people like Troy Ave, people that have or seem to have very little regard for human life, his or someone else's. Mm-hmm. It's scary. So listening to him talk as many times as I did, he said a lot. I try my best to avoid people like that. I found it kind of interesting, and I know I've seen people comment on the fact that he was doing the interview with Charlamagne, mm-hmm. who is friends with Tex. Mm-hmm. What is y'all's take on that? Because I don't mind that.
That's Charlamagne's.
Charlamagne's a professional.
Yeah.
I think he can distinguish between the two, right?
Yeah.
But
at that, the facts of the case have not actually came out at all. So right now I'm doing my job with someone who at the moment people want to hear from.
My only problem
I will say he was a little quieter than usual. I'm not saying he was silent.
He should have been. That was radio gold. Mm-hmm. I keep hearing people say that Charlamagne was quiet.
When you have
a nigga up there speaking the shit that Troy Ave was speaking, you just let him go. Just go. Why would I jump in?
Well, that was like when we said Tax in the Beans interview. Mm-hmm. Tax said like three words, and it was the perfect interview.
Mm-hmm. No, that's different.
But no, of course it's different.
Tax said three words because out of respect.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but also Beans was going on his own. You didn't need to interrupt him with a question that didn't matter.
Of course.
I think Charlamagne, of course I can't prove this. This is just from what I saw. To your point, I think Charlamagne was also a little uncomfortable as well as any human being would be with what's happened with this case and his not involvement in the case, but his friendship with Tax, who's now jammed up on the gun.
Why should he be uncomfortable?
A friend is a... I mean, if there's some...
Why should Charlamagne be uncomfortable?
If there's some type
his
of...
His friend is involved in the situation.
Yeah. No, I'm talking about... Yeah, with Troy Ave, though. Why should he be uncomfortable interviewing Troy Ave?
Because his friend is involved directly in that situation with the guest.
But that situation went on for years.
Yeah, but now it's at a different level, though.
I know. So, and that's my when I watched that.
A much different level than some podcast to tweet shit. This is way fucking different.
But that's my point. So when y'all watched that interview, it didn't bother anybody that maybe, just maybe, and we don't know this, maybe if Charlamagne and Troy have that conversation sooner, maybe some things happen differently.
Nah. Oh yeah, I mean,
because Charlamagne maybe can get through to Tax.
That's after everything said.
And I'm not blaming Charlamagne for that. Yeah, of course not. I'm not that stupid. Mm-hmm. But that was just like a weird twist to me. And then I had to watch the interview again because I forgot that dynamic. So then I wanted to go back and see Charlamagne's interview style with this guy. I want to pray for Troy Ave. I just want to pray for Troy. I had a whole long hot take to get into all of the stupid shit that he said. And maybe ways that this could have been avoided. But after watching that Trife Gangsta interview, like...
I think that first of all, you know, you got to remember life was lost. So rest in peace to...
yes.
100%.
Condolences to his family. But I think that Trife Gangsta, his interview, he spoke from a place where I think everybody totally understood what he was saying and where he was coming from. And things he was saying made sense. You know what I mean? When you take the whole thing into account. But above all of this, man, the entire situation to me is just so unfortunate, man, because I feel like it's so much shit that happened, and I still really don't know why any of this happened. Like, that's the crazy part about all this shit. I still don't even really understand how it even got this far and all of these events happened.
We don't know what happened.
Yeah, like, I'm just saying, like, we know that whatever happened in that room, it should have never came to that, is what I'm saying. Like, I still don't understand the whole thing, honestly. Like, I really don't. But it's just unfortunate because I think there's so many people involved that had so much going on, so much positive shit going on for themselves. Yeah. And it's just unfortunate, man. Like, you know, as guys growing up in the hood, man, it seems like we always get in our own ways at some point. And my thing is, we got to stop doing that. We got to stop getting in our own way. And we got to start noticing when we find our lane and we doing some dope shit, stay there. You know what I'm saying? Fuck all that other shit in the past and all that negative shit. Stay on that dope shit and keep doing what you're doing over here. Like, and we got to stop getting in our own way, man. But
sometimes your ego will void your progression. And like I've said before, the energy that you manifest, you eventually have to face. So you should be very careful with the type of energy that you create. Especially when egos are involved, that will halt your progression for positive things.
Mm-hmm. Egos. I like that word. That word popped up a lot when I was watching this interview, because he just kept giving off information without knowing he was giving off information. Mm-hmm. At one point, there was a 5-minute stretch where he sounded like him and his mom were aggravated that Banger's family decided to bury him in North Carolina.
Yeah. I mean, but that's everything that Trife touched on. That's why I said everything that he touched on was like.
Watching that Trife gangster interview was so informative to me. Well, shit, Troy touched on it too. But when Trife said it, I understand. When Troy said it, it's like confirmation. You're not really sitting here telling me that you calling the deceased mother to say, why are you burying your child in North Carolina?
Yeah.
Trife handled that interview better than I would. I would have been screaming after I watched that Troy Ave interview, and you're speaking those type of words about my mother who just buried her son. But that's my brother.
You can tell Trife is an OG. He's an older head.
He handled that beautifully.
Like, he's not, you know, I mean, he's an older,
definitely an intelligent guy.
Yeah. It sounded like, you know, I take him at his word. I don't think he wanted to be there sitting there doing an interview at all. I think it was a million other things he'd rather been doing.
Yeah.
But because that Troy Ave interview surfaced,
he had to.
Everybody's family has to have a representative to speak for the family.
Right. Yeah. It's unfortunate all the way around.
It is funny, though, after all that Troy is now calling these other rappers weirdos. They're the weirdos. I find that very ironic.
How come nobody... What's wrong with saying he was wrong about that? Why he won't say that? When Charlamagne asked him that at the end... I remember you was calling niggas weird, so forth and so on.
I mean, but you had to listen to the first hour or what we've already seen and what Troy has given out to the public. He's very arrogant. He will never admit if he's wrong. He will dance around a reason to make himself right, even if he sounds stupider to do so. But I also think I've never been a Troy Ave defender here, but I do want to take into play that he was shot, went to jail, came out, got shot in the head. My mind's going to be a little fucked up. Let's keep in... I know he's had all these semantics before, but let's also keep that into play. I know it's cool to kill Troy Ave, but let's remember, as much as he kept saying, I got a bullet in my head, and he's trying to sound like Pac, and we can laugh about that, he still has a bullet in his head. Let's take that into consideration.
Yeah, my mind's going to be nuts, too. Yeah.
And I think which is so ironic but sad about this whole thing with depression and mental illness, I think... I can only speculate, but I think Troy Ave is going through a lot of mental illness right now. I think his brain is going nuts, and all he knows how to do is say, hey, look, I spent $1 million, check Instagram since I got out of jail. I think this whole... This was a traumatic experience. Your friend died in front of you, you're shot, you come out, people are still trying to kill you. He's going to be traumatized, but he's got to play it off because that's the persona that he's given to the world forever. And now he has to keep up with that persona, which is why it sucks to give people something you're not, because you always got to keep that up. And again, I don't know Troy. I didn't grow up with him. I don't know if he is a drug dealer or not, and I do not give a fuck. But he has kept up with this persona of being a tough guy and being this Brooklyn kingpin, and now he's got to continue to do that.